The smartphone display, the television or the gaming monitor, if you take the any type of display, the frame rate and the refresh rate are the two terms which are quite often used with these displays. And many times people find these two terms a bit confusing. So in this video, let us understand what is frame rate and refresh rate. And let's start with the frame rate. So the frame rate is defined for the content which is going to be shown on these displays. So if we take the case of any video, then it consists of the multiple frames or the still images which are slightly different from one another. And when these different frames are shown sequentially in a very short interval, then it gives the human eye an illusion of the motion. So the frame rate defines the rate at which the frames appears on the display. And it is defined as the number of frames per second or simply by the FPS. And if you see worldwide, the different types of content are displayed at the different frame rate. For example, the movies are displayed at the 24 frames per second. While if you see the standard television shows, then they are displayed at either a 25 frames per second or at the 30 frames per second. And here, the frame rate differs from country to country. So the countries which follows the NTSC standard, the standard frame rate in these countries is 30 frames per second. While the countries which follows the PAL standard, in these countries the frame rate is 25 FPS. So apart from these television shows, if we talk about the high action sports or some live broadcast, then it is broadcasted at 60 FPS. And apart from that, if we talk about the games, then usually they are played at 60 or higher frame rates. And the content provided by the video sharing or the streaming services on the internet varies from 20 FPS to 60 FPS. So as you can see, the different type of content is provided at different frames per second. And when we watch or interact with this content on our smartphone display or on the television, then the refresh rate comes into the picture. So basically, the refresh rate defines how many times per second the display is getting updated. So for some television display, if the refresh rate is 60 Hz, then it means that the display will get updated at 60 times per second. So the typical refresh rate of today's monitor and the television is 60 Hz. But there are some displays which are also available at higher refresh rates. And usually there is a belief that the higher refresh rate gives the better viewing experience. But actually, it depends on the frame rate of the content which is going to be shown on the display. So for example, if you watch a 30 FPS content on either a 60 Hz or the 120 Hz display, then you won't feel much difference in terms of the viewing experience. So in case of the 60 Hz display, the same frame is displayed twice per second, while in case of the 120 Hz display, the same frame will be displayed 4 times per second. On the other end, if you are watching any movie which is filmed at 24 frames per second, then on the 60 Hz display, it is shown using the pull-down technique. That means every alternate frame is displayed 3 times and the 2 times respectively on the display screen. And except some few panning shots, this technique won't get noticed by the human eye. On the other end, if the same film is displayed on the 120 Hz display, then each frame is displayed 5 times per second. So in short, to get the better viewing experience, the refresh rate of the display should be more than the frame rate of the content. So if you watch a 30 FPS content on a 60 Hz or the 120 Hz TV, then it won't make much difference in terms of the viewing experience. But this high refresh rate displays will be very useful when you are interacting with the content which is displayed on the screen. For example, with the high refresh rate display on the smartphone, when you are scrolling the screen or interacting with the screen, then it gives you the smoother experience. Or even when you are playing the game with the high frame rates on such screen, then it gives you the smoother experience. So let's say you are playing some game on the PC which renders the frame at the 120 FPS. So to play such game, the native refresh rate of the display should be at least 120 Hz. So if you play such game on the 60 Hz monitor, then it can show only 60 frames per second. On the other end, let's say you have a 120 Hz display and the PC is able to output the frames at the 90 FPS. So if there is a no synchronization between the monitor and the graphics card, then you might see a screen tearing while playing the game. That means the information of two or more frames will get displayed on the same frame. So to avoid such screen tearing, the different synchronization techniques like G-Sync and the FreeSync can be used. So to use such technology, both monitor and the graphics card should support these technologies. So in case of the G-Sync, there is some special chip in the display which communicates with the graphics card. And in a way, it lets the monitor to vary its refresh rate to match the frame rate of the graphics card. Or vice versa, the graphics card can match its frame rate based on the maximum refresh rate of the display. So this AMD's FreeSync is similar to the G-Sync technology, but it doesn't require the proprietary chip in the monitor. And instead, this FreeSync relies on the DisplayPort's adaptive sync specification. So in short, using this synchronization technology, it is possible to use even lower refresh rate monitors with the high-end GPUs. Or vice versa, the higher refresh rate monitors with the low-end GPUs. But of course, with the high refresh rate monitors, the gaming experience would be much smoother. And today, not only 120Hz, but even 240 or 480Hz displays are also available. And these displays claims to provide the motion blur-free viewing experience with the high frame rates. So for these displays, the native refresh rate is still either 60 or 120Hz, but using the different techniques like interpolation and the black frame insertion, virtually they increase the frame rate of the display. And using this, they tries to reduce the motion blur. So in case of the interpolation, based on the current frame and the next frame, the display itself generates the intermediate frames. While in case of the black frame insertion, to reduce the motion blur, the alternate black frames is inserted between the regular frames. So using these few techniques, the TV manufacturers markets the high refresh rate displays. So in conclusion, the high refresh rate displays are only good when the content is also available at the high frame rates. So I hope in this video, you understood what is frame rate and the refresh rate and how they are related to each other. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to this channel for more such videos.